welcome back to Gator Snapper Playthrough of The Legend of Zelda Twilight Princess, where we stand foot at the Temple of Time and some shit. I think I don't remember if I put the sword back in last week, but if I didn't, we're gonna do it now. But yeah, we need to put the sword in, open the temple, and then, what do you know, we're fucking... Damn, we're already on another temple now that I think about it. Good deal. Alright, let's, wait. Oh, sword. Oh, wait. Hold on. It's really hard to stick the Master Sword in where it needs to go. Nope. Alright, well, that was not... I guess I did it last week? I don't remember. You know, I guess this episode did start with me initially facing this direction, so maybe it was already right? Or maybe I'm just entirely wrong. Maybe I'm entirely wrong in my thinking here. Pretty sure I would have noticed something, actually, thinking about it. Like, my sword... I'm pretty sure once it's, like, stuck in there, there's a big, obvious, like, pathway. Yeah, no, I'm very certain that is the case. The fuck's going on here? I wasn't able to put the sword in the ground. Or maybe I just didn't finagle close enough up to it. Hold on, let's go check this out again. This is a great way to start an episode. Gator Snapper has so many false starts, doesn't even know how to open the Temple of Time. Like, it's gotta be sword. Gotta be sword? Sword? I'm right up on top of it. B. Slash. Huh. Well, this is embarrassing. I guess let's look around. Hold on, Midna, what do you got to say? Talk to you. Let me talk to you. There are two mirror shards. That's not helpful. That is so not helpful, Midna. Ooh, boy. I just don't remember if I opened the thing last week. Oh, God. Oh, man. This is embarrassing. What if I need to be a wolf? Why would I need to be a wolf, though? Why would being a wolf somehow be useful in this scenario? And actually, you know what? Speaking of, that'd be another interesting thing for implicating... is it here? Oh, it was right here all this time. Another good use of the wolf at this point would be if, oh, yeah, there it is, just right there. Is if when you stuck... You had to, like, stick the sword in to open up the Temple of Time, and then you did, like, either the whole temple or a huge part of the temple only as the wolf. Like, you had to do it as the wolf. That, I think, would have been a good little part for this temple. Because, like, the whole idea is your sword is, like, needed to keep the thing open. Also, we got that fucking ominous choir. Plus, there's a bug somewhere around here that I'd like to capture. I do plan on doing... there it is. I do plan on doing the magic armor thing. Because I found out it's really simple. Like, I know all the things I have to do for it. I just need to raise money, and then I could either raise extra money, or I could just do the, I could do the, like, get the hot spring water to the town, or to the Goron, rather, and that's all I have to do. So, that is probably what I'm going to do, because it'll be cheaper. I'll probably do it off-camera, too. I don't know, I could do it on camera also. If it's, like, right before the, if I haven't been doing it off-camera by the time I get to, like, the end, that's when I'll do it. I'll do it, like, before the final temple, I'll be like, alright, here's another mission. And here we are with... Oh, God, this place actually looks pretty cool. It's barren, like Tales of Vesperia, but it still feels good. Like, it feels like it's supposed to look like this. I guess it's because there's design stuff at other places. I don't know. Anyways, sword. Go! See, this would be the perfect time. You leave the sword stuck in there, and you're forced to turn back into a wolf. Except I guess it's also implied that Midna is the one that's carrying the shard all on her own. It's not like it's... I think it should have stayed stuck in Tuck. Although then, I guess, how would he transform into a wolf normally at other times? I don't know. Hello. Ugh. Ugh. I hate that thing. It just had to follow me. It couldn't wield the Master Sword, so it had to use me for its fucking... its own purposes. Next time I see Uku, I'm killing her. I guess... I don't know. Did they have to imply that, like, yeah... Did they have to show that the chicken had to go through in order for you to go through the fucking stained glass window? I don't know. Gator Snapper's just finding ways to complain. Ooh, hey, the color's back. Thank God. Yeah. So this is the Temple of Time. You know, it's weird. I remember this temple being cool, like, to look at especially, but I cannot for the life of me remember anything within it. I don't remember any of the puzzles. I remember the final boss. I don't remember the mini-boss, though. Unless it's a Lizalfo, which I think is unlikely. Oh, you know what? The mini-boss might be a Darknut, too. I think this is where you first fight a Darknut. And actually, it might just be, like, you only fight Darknuts... Like, it's only a mini-boss in this game rather than, like, a main enemy. Hello. Tuck, don't you think there's something odd about that statue? In the grove and in the temple entry, there are always matching ones on each side, but there's only one here. I mean, maybe they lost track of symmetry. I don't fucking know. We don't know what they were doing, like, 10,000 years ago. Yeah, well, why don't you just use your senses to take a look around instead of being a smartass, huh? Yeah, ever think about that?
God, man, I'm fine. I'll turn into a wolf and I'll start using my senses.
But then I'll have to forget my new favorite scent, which was, oh no, I guess we just see that there was indeed a statue here once.
I knew it. There was one more here originally. I'm a genius. We need to find the other statue in this temple that matches that one.
Cool. And then, you know, I just realized they completely copied this. Well, not completely copied this, but this was like a thing in Wind Waker too when you got to that Temple of Time, wasn't it? Where it's like, you just basically would copy, you'd command statues to follow you around to places.
That's a ripoff. I don't like it.
Oh, well, whatever. Ain't nothing to worry about. What do I actually do right now? So I got this. That doesn't activate. Oh, you know what? I got some pots. And I got that big old door. That big old door won't open until I get the statue. Hold on. There actually is, like, nowhere else to go, is there? Well, I got... there's gotta be a weight. Yeah, I'm stupid. There's the weight pad right over there. Or, sorry, the pressure pad. That's what they call it. Alright, here we go. Easy. I solved the puzzle. There you go. Yeah. I think I have to use the heavy ones. I don't know. I might have been able to just use a normal pod. Who knows? Either way, we've done it this way, so we're going to stick with this way. Now, let's see. God, yeah, this temple's not bad to look at. And I haven't experienced, like, the bullshit it has to offer yet, so I don't know if there's, like, something wrong with it there. But, like, why don't I remember anything about this temple? It seems neat. Like, I don't remember, like, what I did playing with it, but, when I was on the Wii U version, I got to this point, and I remember, like, I went through, like, all the temples really fast from what I remember. So, I don't know. This is just one big thing of, like, Gator Snapper can't remember, and he's making a big deal about it.
Maybe it's part of the Temple of Time. Once you leave it, you lose your memories because of time stuff. Yeah, ever think of it like that?
I don't know if it's probably like that. I think I might need the spinny doodad thing. Spinny doodad thing might do me some favors. Actually, you're right there.
Not so fast, bitch. This time I have use of you. At last, this is it. This is where I've been trying to get to. The ancient technology of our people sleeps in this place. We searched all over. And now we're so close I can smell it. Oh, I'm going to send my attack drone son to go fetch whatever it is we need in here. And just grows teeth and flutters around. Those things are creepy. Once we find that thing, we can go home at last. Oh, gracious, yes. Young man, can I cut you a deal? We're so close, so please help us find what we're looking for.
And you know what? Ancient technology sounds pretty cool. I highly doubt your people created it, but I'll help you find it. But only so I can use it. You got that? Creepy little chicken. Oh yes, I'm sure we can strike a deal. Now we're both figuring out how we can fucking betray each other. Also, hello. You know what? I haven't used the spinny doodad in combat. Let's go ahead and do that. Heya! Have at thee, knave! Can I actually kill enemies with it? Ha! Heya! Come at me! This is a very pathetic fight. Ha! 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 There we go. Well, I mean, I do damage with it. It's very hard to do a spinner-only playthrough of this game, I have to say. Doing combat with it. I just, like, if it's like Devil May Cry, because Devil May Cry does fucking wonders with extra weapons combat stuff. Like, I think that would have been cool if they used the items like that. Like, you could use a claw shot somehow as a weapon. Actually, rather than saying that, that's what they... I shouldn't have broken those pots, should I? Whoops, my bad. But yeah, unless I can stand here and do something? No. Rather than, saying that's what they should have done in this game, they could do that in, like, a new Zelda game. I guess that actually just sounds like fucking Hyrule Warriors now, doesn't it? I don't know, they could do it. Like, it doesn't seem like it'd be the hardest thing to do. Just like, a Zelda game is like Devil May Cry, but also still more like Breath of the Wild. The open worldness of Breath of the Wild, but the combat of Devil May Cry. Because combat in Breath of the Wild was not that great, I have to say. Like, I mean, people could probably be like, the combat in Breath of the Wild was great. I was not a fan of it. Means no slight to those who think combat in Breath of the Wild is great. I don't think I'm right. It's just my opinion of it. That's, like, the hardest fucking thing to say, especially on a public, I guess, forum. Being like, I don't think it's bad, I just don't like it. And then people are like, if you don't like it, then that must mean you think it's bad. I don't know, I can have an opinion, I swear. I swear to Criminy. Criminy Christ. Actually, they gave me arrows, so I figure I have to use the arrows for something, but... I know what I have to use them for. Presumably. Otherwise, I'm about to trap myself. It's gonna be very embarrassing. There we go. Yay, it did work like I thought it did. See, that wasn't even a... Like, that's an okay puzzle to have, too. Oh, it's our first level. It's Lizolfo. That's what they're called. All right. Well, come on. Finish. There you go. Oh, come on. That was even in his body. Hold on. I got another chance. Nope. Do not have another chance. All right. Whatever. There. We killed it the boring way. I guess I've learned never to fucking try to finish an enemy on the stairs. I learned that in college, too. Yeah. Maybe shouldn't be saying things like that, but whatever. This is where we're at right now. Hello. All right. And finish. There you go. That did the trick. You know, see, and this is cool. With the Lizolfos, you actually are kind of doing this sort of stuff where you're using combat moves pretty often. Like, I don't know. I doubt it's just something for the Lizolfos. Like, it's not only specific with the Lizolfos where you have to, like, you do fun combat tricks like that. It just felt like that's the only time where the enemies were coming at me in a way where it excused? Is excused the word I'm looking for? Warranted. Where it warranted using all those fun little combat tricks. Maybe it's just me. I don't know. But it just felt like that was the case right there, right? Like, I was having a grand old fucking time, like, using all my tricks and stuff there. My techniques, rather. I shouldn't call them tricks. I'll probably upset the old dude that taught me all these tricks. Yeah. He's like, don't call them that. It makes it sound like you're a prostitute. You know, turning tricks. It's like, dude, that's not... No, you can say it's just something that was just tricky. Doesn't have to mean you're a prostitute. And he's like, I guess I've been out of the loop for a while now. I like this guy. I like this version of him that I've created in my mind. Alright, let's just fucking open this here gateway. Probably activate creepy little fucking tiki statue there. Or I don't know, maybe tiki statue comes later. Maybe once I come back through this little hallway. Tiki statue? Actually, huh. Oh, it slipped off the fucking... Okay, hold on. And don't let me stand on it, otherwise it's going to activate the cutscene for nothing. There you go. Yeah, there we go. Oh, and there's even a little fucking grabby doodad up there. Okay, cool. Well, what about you? I could have sworn you were going to try and fight me. Yep, okay, I just had to get near him. Never mind. Easy shit, though. Hoo-wee! There you go. Oh, yeah, they're fucking violent when they die. Yeah, you gone? Why did I do that? Did that... Yep, okay, cool. I was hoping it would do something like this. It's a big chest. Is it going to be a small key, or is it going to be a heart piece? I hope it's a heart piece. Oh, you know, I forgot. I haven't collected the compass and map yet, so... Yep, there we are. Yay. I wish... Maybe... I don't know. Maybe in later Zelda games. I haven't played all of them. Or maybe in a future Zelda game. The maps could be something you'd buy from somebody, like, before you go into the dungeons. They could be in a town beforehand or something. And that person could be kind of like, whoa, how are you actually exploring all these places and mapping them out? He could be, like, kind of a rogue character. Like, he sneaks through all the places just to map them. I think that'd be cool. Sounds like that guy from that game I fucking played forever ago. Lichdom Battle Mage, the Hawk. Or I think he's called the Hawk. And yeah, his whole purpose was scouting. And then there could be DLC you could buy where you play as that character that does only scouting. I mean, yeah, you could. Specifically for a Zelda game. I mean, they could have done that too with, baby spiders. They could have done that too for, Lichdom Battle Mage. I think that would have been fun. Because sometimes you want to try a different style of approaching things, and Lichdom Battle Mage really only had the one style of approaching things. I mean, it had, like, all the different ways of, like, making spells and whatnot, which was pretty cool. You could customize magic like a motherfucker. But, specifically, oh, I can't fight with that yet. Well, maybe I can, actually. Hold on, I'll go back to it later. Alright, you know what, sir? You've asked for my Mortal Draw! Hey-ah! Mortal Draw's fucking OP. I forgot it takes like 10 years for Link to put away the fucking sword after he does it, though. He has to do the fancy version. That's the biggest drawback to the Mortal Draw. That's not what I wanted out. Yeah, you have to show off once you use the Mortal Draw. There we go. Easy as pie, right? Like, it's busted. Why did I do that? Well, at least I got a rupee and some arrows. That's a good deal. Fuck, oh, and some hearts. I'll take those. God. You know, when I heard that they were doing hero mode for the Wii U version, I'd assumed it was going to be like, oh, the enemies just do extra damage and you take less, you take more damage. No, fuck, I already said that. Enemies do extra damage and you would have less hearts to pick up. That's what I meant to say. But from what I found out, I think is not a good way to sound smart and knowing. But I think it's just you only have 3 hearts the entire fucking playthrough. And that does not sound like a good time to me. Like, I think it's fine if they just do extra damage. Being capped out at 3 hearts just sounds fucking impossible. But that's the whole purpose of those game types. It's supposed to be challenging, because then it's fun. I mean, I'm fine with, like, dying in one hit and as, like, a level of difficulty in a game. I think that's fair. What I think is fucking obnoxious is when an enemy has just, like, 1 billion fucking hit points, takes no damage, and, yeah, stuff like that. It's really fucking obnoxious. I just don't, like, it's the whole, it did that in Fallout, it did that in, like, Fallout 3, New Vegas, 4, like, that's not a good, I don't think that's a good way to, like, do difficulty, because it's just fucking boring, it just takes forever. Berseria does it too, and I hate it, it's not a good time. And also, what should I do? Should I try and get the little statue across first? Actually, this is, like, an elevator or something, if I remember correctly. Push that? I mean, I could also just go the way with the small key. Like, that's something I have an option to do right now. In fact, doing this might just be wasting time. Link, your little hats. Oh, I see what I'm supposed to do now. I need this up there. Okay. Well, what's the purpose of all the little spiders? Are they just here to have... You know what? I know I'm here to have a good time. Yeah! Alright, let's do this a little bit. Whee! See? This would be a great time if right now I had, like, the momentum. Like, if this was a Devil May Cry style game, like, bouncing off the walls all over the place, killing these guys would be so fun. Be so fun. God, why don't I make games? Actually, rather than why don't I make games, why don't I tell people who know how to make games, like, things I think would be fun? I guess that's just being a fucking reviewer on a fucking forum, isn't it? Like, every time that someone's like, take our survey, I'm a great survey taker. Which actually reminds me, if you ever see a job that's called Survey Taker, don't take it. Those are, like, the fucking worst kinds of jobs. Well, I don't know about that. You know, I don't know entirely. I might be mixing up with something else. I don't know if it's the survey jobs that are also, like, the whole pyramid scheme thing, which there are a lot of those floating around out there. Look out for them. But, yeah. Pretty sure the survey jobs are also that, where it's just, like, you're basically just, You basically, it's just a pyramid scheme, which, I don't know, bad time. Don't get into those. They're just a fucking, a way to kill your fucking time and make, I don't know. It's a scheme for a reason. You don't want to do them. That's the long and short of it, I guess. Let's pop this boy back up too, by the way. Hi-ya! Oh god, actually that reminds me, speaking of jobs that are a scam, I got a call back for an interview once, when I was, like, applying for jobs. And I was like, oh, this is good, I've actually been looking for a real job for a while now, not fucking TJ Ass Max. But, I fucking set up the interview and everything, I was like, oh man, this is great, I finally have, I have an opportunity to work in the environmental field. Oh, did not see that thing coming at me. I called them, we talked, I got information, I didn't get, that's the thing, I didn't quite get enough of the information. I set up for an interview, which, where they were doing it online, and I missed the first interview because my fucking code to sign in wouldn't work, and I was like, oh fuck, this is terrible. Thankfully, I was able to sort it all out, well, kind of thankfully. I was able to sort it out and get an interview set up for the next day. When between that time period, I was like, I should research what this place does, and I did. I found out what's the best way to describe it? It was a job for canvassing, and for those that don't know, canvassing is basically telemarketing but in person. And once I found that out, I was a little turned off. In fact, I was very turned off. I was like, I don't want to do that as a job. Like, you just go up to you drive all over fucking town, which for me would have been in Austin, which is a fucking clusterfuck to drive through in the first place. So I would have been driving through town, going up to people's doorways, and basically bothering them, being like, you want to sign up for this fucking thing? Which, for one, I don't even like talking to people normally. For two, if I had to do it, like, in that style, where I'm trying to fucking get them to, like, buy something I might not even want, like, something I might not agree with, because I feel like I'd hate that job pretty quick. I don't know. The whole thing was just, like, not my cup of tea, and I felt really bad because I was talking to a lady that helped me reset up my, like, interview appointment, and, like, they went through the trouble of setting me up for that, like, next interview, and then I didn't even fucking turn my computer on that day. I was so turned off from, like, having to, like, sign up for that job. I was like, I don't even want to try getting an interview for this job. It just sounds like trash. Which, I don't know. I guess there's, like, a moral to this story, I guess. Mainly being research what it is you're getting into before you get into it. Because, yeah. That job would have fucking... It wouldn't have killed me. It just would have been a real bad time is all. I would not have been happy working at a job like that. And I guess on that happy note, let's open this chest. Maybe it'll be like a 50 plus rupee. Or maybe it'll be a small key. Nope, it's a 20 rupee. I still can't get over the fact they put like the small keys in little chest and big chest. But anyways, on that note, I'm gonna end this episode right here. Next week, I guess we'll fucking use that small key door that I skipped out on. So yeah, it's been a Gator Snapper playthrough. See you guys in the next one. Later, everybody.